Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? As the moon orbits the Earth, despite having the same side facing towards us all the time, we can actually peek around the edge thanks to libration, or when the moon does this. On Monday evening, we can see Mare Crisium, with the nearby Macrobius deeply shadowed. Can you see the terraces along the walls? To the north, along the Terminator, are Atlas and Hercules. Look for the dark floor areas inside Hercules and a small crater. To the south is the flooded partial crater Fracastorius at the southern edge of Mare Nectaris. And just south of there is Piccolomini, which should be showing the top of its 2-kilometer-tall central mountain peak. By Tuesday, many of those same craters are still worth seeking out and observing, though they've changed in appearance somewhat. While the three large craters of Catharina, Cyrillus, and Theophilus dominate the Terminator south of Mare Tranquillitatis, let's look north of there. There are some features separating Mare Serenitatis from Tranquillitatis. Plinius is here, the 18 kilometers across crater Dawes is next, which may be the hardest one to see, and then Mons Argeus and Mons Vitruvius. But notably, on December 11th, 1972, the lunar lando of Apollo 17 touched down in this area, just south of the crater Littrell. And now this week's dark sky fact. Fully shielded lights that use motion sensors to turn on only when necessary, and that turn off when unneeded, are the most efficient way to light up a given area and maintain safety. Wednesday is when things get interesting. Yes, be sure to look at Aristoteles and Eudoxus north of Montes Caucasus, which are all nicely lit and shadowed. But notice this feature here, along the southeastern limb of the moon. That would be Mare Australe, a 600-kilometer diameter feature that is a bit different than most Mare that have few craters in them. Mare Australe has lots of craters, which should make this a fascinating area to observe going forward in the week. On the 12th, the previous day's craters are still good to view, but now Aristillus, Autolycus, and Archimedes are the more dramatic-looking craters near Montes Apenninus. Mons Hadley is a prominent feature at the northern end of this mountain range, and just south of it is a deep pocket of darkness. This is where Apollo 15 landed back on July 30th, 1971. At the time, NASA called this the most successful manned flight ever achieved. On Friday, Montes Apenninus seemed to trail all the way out to Eratosthenes, but this time, we'll look well south. The massive walled plain of Clavius is hard to miss, with its many craterlets inside its 225 kilometers across diameter. To the south of that is Mauritius, and at this time, the way the sun hits it, there appears to be a massive wall here. Be sure to swing back up the southeastern edge and view Mare Australis again, too. By Saturday, Copernicus, with its ringed walls and 1,200-meter-high central peak, is an ideal target for most any small telescope. To its north, Montes Carpatus extend east to west, with the craters Reinhold and Landsberg to the south. And finally on Sunday, my friend Pauli's favorite crater Gassendi is revealed on the northern edge of Mare Humorum, and its satellite craters forming deep shadows contrasted by brightly lit walls on the opposite side. Take some time to view the moon this week. As the closest celestial object to Earth, there's clearly a lot to see. Saturn is largely slipping low enough to be difficult to observe clearly, but by the end of the week, Venus is close to conjunction with the ringed planet, making for a nice naked eye view. Neptune is in the same field of view as a star of equal magnitude, but look early in the week so the moon doesn't foul the view. And in the morning, Jupiter is high enough to observe by 2 a.m., while Mars continues to hug the horizon. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.